I'm a believer. I believe in the system and I believe in justice. I dedicated more than 30 years to the criminal justice system and the assignment of blame. Tonight, I'm not angry. I'm just dumbfounded, disheartened, and disappointed. Over the long-awaited, often delayed Inspector General's report on the actions of the Department of Justice and the FBI in the handling of the Clinton email investigation. The report's conclusion, 568 pages later, FBI Director James Comey was insubordinate. There were a few mistakes and a few errors in judgment, and although there was some bias, there was no evidence of bias in the handling of the email investigation. This report mimics Comey's conclusion in the email case itself. Both the Inspector General and Comey make out a provable case and then conclude there is no case. Nothing changes. The deep state hard at work. I don't know about you, but I am so tired of lessons learned. They say Comey deviated from the rules. Deviated from the rules? Comey and his FBI cabal fixed a case. Hillary not indicted for her crimes, yet an effort to frame Donald Trump for no crime. And no bias in the conclusion? Because no one said, yes, I was biased, or simply said, I'm not biased. That's it? Every day in this country, murder cases are tried where there is no admission of guilt and only denials. And yet jurors decide the accused's intentions based on what they say, what they do, and what they don't do. Determining someone's intent is not that difficult. Intent can be determined like this. Take a look at these texts. We'll stop him from being president. It's like an insurance policy in the unlikely event you die before when you're 40. Hillary should win 100 million to zero. America will get what the public deserves. And let's add a new one, folks, from an FBI lawyer. Viva la resistance. Gee, isn't that Obama and Hillary's mantra? You don't have to be a rocket scientist to understand those statements. They not only indicate a biased, hateful state of mind, they imply unequivocally a willingness to take official action to impact the election. How do you pledge resistance against a president while you're investigating him? And the Inspector General says there's no evidence of improper considerations impacting the investigation? Folks, Comey didn't just deviate from well-established practices. He didn't even do an investigation. He covered for it by having the same people handle both the Hillary case and the Trump frame-up. Folks, it doesn't happen this way. This case is not about mistakes or errors in judgment. It's about a deep state trying to drag a crook across the presidential finish line and trying to destroy the man Americans wanted in the Oval Office. Example. Jim Comey said he had to step into Loretta Lynch's role because she wouldn't recuse herself after secretly meeting with Bill Clinton on the tarmac. That's baloney. He didn't just step into her shoes to prevent an injustice. He stepped into her role to declare Hillary not guilty. And Jim, if you're such a champion of truth and justice, why did you go along with Lynch calling a year-long criminal investigation a matter? Why did you say Hillary was extremely careless so as not to use the words grossly negligent, which would make her actions criminal? And when brought before Congress, Jim, you punt and say, you don't think grossly negligent applies. First-year law students across this country laughed at you. And you take a case from normal field office agents to investigate with no grand jury, no search warrant, no subpoenas, and you give away immunities like candy with no requirement that those immunized testify against anyone. Investigators across the country laughed at you. And when you found Hillary's deleted emails that were marked C for classified, you decide to believe her when she said it was only a reference to the letter C in the alphabet, in spite of the fact that there was no A or B before C. People in the intelligence community laughed at you, Jim. And when you wrote an exoneration of Hillary months before you interviewed her and 16 main witnesses saying it's done all the time, Attorneys across the country laughed at you. Come on, Jim. You acquitted her because, like Hillary, you, Lynch, and even Obama communicated government information via private emails. And you placed as many Trump haters as you could, like your friend Mueller in charge of the make-believe Trump collusion on the case. I want to know, from this Inspector General's report, why don't we know what judge signed the FISA warrant? Who renewed the FISA warrant, and what actions they're taking now, now that they know they were conned by a corrupt FBI agent? And why was Peter Strzok, arguably the most corrupt FBI agent in American political history, put on the Mueller team to destroy Donald Trump with his girlfriend, Lisa Page? Why is he still working, and why am I paying his salary? Why is Rod Rosenstein allowed to refuse to provide reports and documents to Congress? And why is he allowed to threaten to subpoena records of those in Congress without any criminal investigation? Why Rosenstein didn't hand over the most incriminating of all the texts? He won't win president. Don't worry, we'll stop him. A clear and unequivocal attempt to obstruct a presidential campaign. Why are the DOJ and the FBI allowed to lie to a federal judge and say, we have no emails between us on the Loretta Lynch, Bill Clinton tarmac meeting? Why can Loretta Lynch lie and use a personal email, a fake name for government business? Tell me, how many times does someone have to lie to an inspector general before they're just not believable? Why does Hillary Clinton, just days after Bill meets the attorney general on that tarmac, say she'll keep Loretta Lynch on as AG if she wins as president? We're not stupid. And why does the IG not recommend a leak prosecution when there are 65 phone calls from a reporter to a top FBI official? Why did Christopher Wray have to be brought to the White House to be convinced that McCabe needs to go? Isn't the FBI supposed to figure that stuff out on its own? I'm worried. I'm really worried. This report is nothing more than a whitewash of the deep state by the deep state itself. There are great people in the FBI, men and women, and I have had the honor of working with them. But they're embarrassed because they know how bad Comey and company destroyed America's confidence in that esteemed FBI. And there are great people in government, many of whom you've seen on this show. Congressman Ron DeSantis, Jim Jordan, Mark Meadows, Devin Nunes, Lee Zeldin, Matt Gaetz, Andy Biggs, Senators Lindsey Graham, Ron Johnson, Chuck Grassley. These people are fighting the deep state as obstructionist Democrats like Pelosi, Schumer, and Schiff stare into the cameras and turn truth on its head. They're not real Democrats. They're demon rats. That's what I said, demon rats. And until the Republicans learn to fight like they do and go with a narrative that no one veers from, they and socialism will run amok in this country. We need people in Washington who believe in truth and justice and are not offended by the term law and order and believe in consequences. This is not a banana republic. This is the United States of America with a justice system that needs to be protected. And it's time for those people who are not interested in supporting President Trump to get out of his way. And that means you, Jeff Sessions. It's time for you to put on your big boy pants and start acting like the AG. And if you can't get on board with this president, then get the hell out of his way. And let me be clear to all you critics, I'm not looking for that job. I'm an ordinary American who was brought up to believe in truth and justice. And like thousands and hundreds of thousands of men and women in law enforcement, we're just damn embarrassed and hang our heads in shame with the likes of Comey and his cabal, as well as the impotent Inspector General's report, which is nothing more than proof the deep state is alive and well in Washington, D.C. That's my open. Tell me what you think on my Facebook page, Twitter, and Instagram, #JudgeShaneem.